we haven't worked out the song yet. It's the pilot.
Okay. Anyway.
Rude.
So it's been broken. So today's topic is literally about baby mamas, the relationship men have with them. Because we can only talk from our perspective, so women may have a different perspective to this. But you know, we're gonna try and be honest and open, and really use personal experiences we've heard from other gentlemen in our circle, and touch upon our men turning soft, and not soft as in like we won't, like we're supposed to beat up our woman and team, but you know, we're losing our status as men, losing the role as a man, like so
all right, so I don't know, so we can start off with, so I'm trying to think about this relates to mothers of child. I like the word baby mothers. I feel like it's important to have a relationship with a mother of your child, or in the case of a woman, the father of your child, because that kid needs both parents, needs a balanced view from both parents to make it in life. But I feel that sometimes, like when things don't work out with the mother of the child, it feels like, might not be the truth, you know, but it feels like they do everything within their power to make your life hard.
Well, a certain amount of women choose to be hurtful, choose to use the child as a weapon against the father.
Yeah.
Try to just make your life a misery.
I feel like a lot of the women that do that, because I've said like many friends who talk about these things to me, I feel like to some degree the women who do these types of things, they're hurt, and are hurting, and they've not taken the time to resolve whatever issues there are that have put them in a situation. So for example, you see like many women, some women are always in abusive relationships, like physically abusive, where the man might put hands on her, do you know what I mean? And then boom, she'll finish with that man after some long period of time of hands being put on her,
the process again.
And she'll find another man who puts hands on her, do you get me? Or some women, will always go for a man who's a player, and she'll be with a man and he'll do his thing playing, and then, you know, she'll finish with that man or he'll finish with her, and she'll get another man who does the exact same thing again.
Is that her fault though?
Here's the thing, it kind of is. And the reason why I say, because I have to take responsibility for myself. So she's got to take responsibility for herself. And the thing of the matter is, if you find yourself continuously getting into a situation, like the saying goes, the definition of insanity is doing the same thing again and again and expecting different results. So if you find yourself in a situation continuously with the same type of man, let's call him, I could say he's a narcissist because that's what many people would say. But let's say the man's got narcissistic tendencies and you find yourself with the same kind of man again. Like, you owe it to yourself, and if you have children, you owe it to your children, to just draw a line. Do you get me?
But how do they recognise them?
Because they'll see a pretty boy, nice hair, nice clothes, whatever, nice everything in it. And they'll automatically be drawn to that. And there'll be another man who probably hasn't got all those things, just got a job, and he's just offering them a dinner and a date, but he's a bit dry. Many of the time, even in my own family, I've heard females in my own family say, oh, but he's boring though.
Yeah, or he's too short, or is this. But what the thing is, it's like, from what I know, from personal experiences, and from stories I've heard, I truly believe, and many women will probably deny this, but I truly believe that women are still in love with the man, to a degree.
When you say in love with the man, what man?
The father of their child.
Oh.
And this is where the pain comes from, I believe.
Okay, that's a good point.
Because I believe
He's
let them down. He's, in many ways, like they feel resentment. They probably feel that he's wasted their time. They're getting older. It's a lot of bitterness.
Yeah, true stories, because of that as well. There's a time factor.
The
waste of age and all that.
Come
that's a serious
shelf life for women.
It's a serious thing.
For men.
It's a serious thing.
I feel that they feel. I don't know if it's.
Also, then, but said, okay. Then obviously not to stop it, so it's carry on. But then because of that, then I can see that you would say that it's not entirely their fault, and then you would say that it's the man's fault as well.
I believe we have to take responsibility.
I think we have to take responsibility for the part that we play in how they turn out.
Because go on.
I'm going to say, go on, you go. So I'm going to say
woman,
something.
At the end of the relationship, is not the woman we met.
Mm-mm.
So I would argue that we've played played a hand
in
changing that woman's perspective
of what a man
of us.
Yeah, yeah.
Of herself. Right. You get me? And based on that, she can only know.
Yeah. We're an experience of what a man is. So here's what I would say, I totally agree with that. Right, that's correct. But also, we spoke about this the other day, and you can't forget this. It's an important thing to forget when we're blaming ourselves, because I think we do accept responsibility. But a lot of the time when it happens, speaking from my own, now I'm just going to drop back onto myself now. Yeah, and this is not about the mother of my child, this is about myself. I have got the ability to recognize that the person that I was when I was the age back in those days that I made those mistakes is not who I am now. So whereas we might have influenced them in negative in things that we did, we also have to remember we was kids.
No, of course, and this is a good point, because we were kids then, and we've grown through the breakup and through everything. We've stepped away, done some self.
Looking at and seeing where we're to blame,
bro.
Seeing where we're to blame.
Come on,
there's been a lot of self. I forgot the
realization.
Self realization. Yeah, to know.
And we don't want to make the same mistakes again.
Yeah,
so what we do, not only our kids, but our future relationships, because we want to improve, we want to grow.
Continuous improvement.
The problem is, they haven't taken the time to get to know the new guy.
And they also haven't taken the time to get to know themselves.
Come on, bro.
Because here's the thing, like we're saying, there's definitely the part that's us, but I think every man in his relationship, right, apart from just the outright cold ass, no regard, no remorse type brother, right, will have at some point, especially if he loved the woman that he was with, he would have had that little feeling of this is the one. But what about what she done? Because here's the thing, she will have done some stuff. And the joke about is the problem is because men do some dumb shit in the end, like
cheat. Let's talk about what
men
do.
Because a man will cheat, that becomes the focus of it.
And this is what I was gonna say, but let's go just before the cheating, because there's a time when a man is solely in love.
Yeah, exactly.
Only has eyes for that woman.
Exactly.
Nothing. He won't sleep. Nothing without thinking about her. So let's go into the things that. Not women in general. Well, women in general.
Anyone can do
some examples of what the woman will do to make a man shift. You get me?
Peace of mind is important.
Peace of mind in what way?
Peace of mind in like when you come home,
you've
grafted.
Yeah.
Yeah. You don't want no stress.
Mm.
And a woman will want to be a man. You say about women trying to become men.
Mm.
Like, I've got an experience of that, which I won't share today, but I know that when women try to step into your shoes, they realise what that really entails. You know what I'm saying?
We're built
differently,
it's
a lot of blood, it's
and
a lot of pressure.
Powered in the wrong hands is handled, can be delivered wrong, should I say.
Okay.
This guy, Flash Thompson, he probably deserved what happened. But just because you can beat him up, doesn't give you the right to. Remember, with great power comes great responsibility.
You know, but what point I'm trying to make is,
let me just go on to the stress, the stress factor then.
So this is what I was going to say before the stress, before the stress.
Yeah, go on.
Fucking
hell. So let me just go on to the stress factor.
Go on.
Going back onto the stress factor here, I want peace of mind when I've had a hard day's life, living the life that I live.
This is what I was going to say. I'm glad you came back.
Yes, go on.
The reality is all women give stress.
That's standard.
All women.
Yes, exactly.
So, if we, I believe as men,
we
need to forget about this perfect woman.
No, there's no perfect woman.
There's none.
There's no perfect
woman. We have to accept the woman for who she is, and accept that across the board, many women carry the same characteristics. And one of the characteristics is moaning. Or we interpret it as moaning. They just want shit done. And we see it as, because we don't do it there and then, and we have to be asked a few times, it's moaning. But really, it's, you know, it's assertiveness.
They which is good,
done, and it is good.
Which is
and
good.
What I've learned here over time is that the woman who loves us, she isn't telling us nothing to do, that's not going to improve us as a man.
That's true. But can't argue with that.
We are lazy.
Can't
characters.
Argue with that.
Yeah.
Don't know about that.
All right, not lazy. Don't get me wrong. Not lazy. Because, bro, we graft hard. And our mind, but I don't understand that.
And it's your thing, because I say that, this is it. Minds don't stop, but no, their minds stop. Again, we have to work on contextualization of things. Yeah, when you talk about the mind, don't stop. Yeah, right. You got to remember what the mind is dealing with on a daily basis.
Of course.
Some of the things which I won't go into.
Of course.
But some of the things are out of a film. Do you get me? So when you're stressing about these things that are going on in your life, in addition to whatever, you need a level of understanding. So
we don't always share what's going on. So we.
But sometimes they can see.
Nah,
sometimes they can see.
No, they can see, but they don't always interpret how it's a... They can't... Unless we share...
Biggest thing? Can I say this? I was talking to a bridge in there the other day, and he was saying to me, I've never cried in front of my woman, and I actually...
That was me.
Okay, it was you. I ain't trying to put you out there like that. But here's the thing. That's sad. That you can't. And that's the reality. You can't, because as soon as you do that, she take this is what you say about a woman becoming a man, she takes you for some idiot, innit? But at the end of the day, you could be tackling anything.
But that's just me. No, there is some man.
No, there are some man. There is some man.
I've spoken to women, bro. Yeah. Sorry to cut you.
Carry on.
And they say to me, bro, the way they talk about their man barding, I just crying all night like a pussy.
I'm tired of this shit.
He's always crying.
Yes, I'm saying.
You get me? And the thing is, when a woman cries, it's cool on the shoulder.
Yeah, you're there. But I'm not saying that a man should be able to. All right, back from our brief intermission.
Cut that, bro. We have to.
Anyway, just in case, back from our brief intermission. Just in case, if you see all the other book went down, But yeah, go on. So where was you? So anyway, I was saying, it's a shame, because obviously you can't cry in front of them.
Yeah.
And I'm not saying that man should cry in front of a woman, but at the end of the day, like, who are you going to go cry to? Your mum? You're going to cry to the man then?
No.
Just to be clear, I'm still not saying that a man should cry in front of his woman.
There's nothing wrong with crying.
But it's more the point that when you're a man and you know that you can't,
No, you can.
No, but you can't.
No, you can't. Listen. You can, yeah.
You can't.
But I know. I truly believe
you can't.
Because this is the thing. Yeah.
Because then she just takes you for an idiot.
Listen, and it's not the first time. Because if you do it once,
then
I believe. Yeah. You can have a China vase. Yeah. They'll call them in. And there can be a hairline crack.
Yeah.
And nobody knows it's there. No, I don't know it's there. She knows it's there.
Yeah.
And if you crack it again and crack it again and crack it again, eventually it's going to break. And you can super glue it back with, but then cracks are there. So I'm all about no cracks.
No cracks.
Yeah, that's what it's about for me, bro. And no cracks is strong. And if it means that I've got a sock, and the only thing is, there's not many things that are going to make me cry anyway, to be honest with you. You get me? Not even pain makes me cry, to be honest. And that's my upbringing. Whereas you probably get beaten if you cry.
True, you get battered for crying.
You know what I'm saying? I've got something to cry for.
So yeah.
Or I didn't see. I grew up with my uncles and aunts. There was no crying. You hold pain. Hence why when we was at school, it's you know, we wasn't one of the weak ones. You know what I'm saying? So crying is alien to me almost. Even at I remember crying at Harley's funeral. I don't know where them tears come from, and they couldn't stop coming, bro. I remember crying.
That's what I'm saying. But even that, because I think that's one of the only, when I say one of the only, but one of the times, you're like tuned by Scarface, never seen a man cry till I seen a man die.
And you see the ones you never learn to love in life. make the choice, let it go, but you can back it up. If you ain't at peace with God, you need to patch it up. But if you're ready, close your eyes and we can set it free. Eliza, man, not scared to die, may he rest in peace. I still got to wonder why I never seen a man cry till I seen that man die.
I think that's an acceptable time for a man to cry, but I'm telling you now, you cry when a man dies, whether it was murdered or whatever, yeah, and that's one of your people, you still potentially can't do that in front of.
I ain't doing it.
There you go.
Facts.
See
it. And the thing is, I'm not doing it because I'm not doing it, and it's not because of I'm hiding. I'm in tune who I am and my emotions. And
so what'd you have done if your missus was there when you was crying at Hardy's funeral and she looked in your face?
I couldn't have stopped.
So what she had done there? She would have some prep.
But you know what? No, I wouldn't have cared though. This is the difference because end of the day, I've lost a friend, you know. And I don't care if the Queen Mother was there, bro. That wasn't me. That was my natural emotions where I was shocked that I couldn't hold them back. And I tried and it felt good just to sit down trying to stop
and let it out.
Never thought I'd be crying in front of a female. You can cry in front of me.
Alright, that's cool. So bring it back then to where we was, because the one we was talking about was the mothers of our children, and ultimately, it seems like what it is, whose fault it is, what's the issue in terms of why they're moving, like they're moving. And I see, it seems to me that obviously you're looking at us as the, and we have to blame ourselves, but you're looking at us.
I'm taking responsibility, bro, personally.
Yeah. No,
because
definitely.
I'll tell you the truth.
You go on.
The mother of my son, when I met her.
Before we just talk about other people.
We are talking about other
people. Yeah, so the mother of some
brother. So my mother.
What's your name again?
Jonathan.
Jonathan.
And listen, keeping in mind, the reason why we split up isn't because I cheated. Jonathan. The reason why Jonathan. Fuck it, man, let's keep it real. Listen, I didn't cheat or nothing, bro.
Yeah.
But I was a workaholic.
True.
Grafting.
True.
Running business.
True.
For the family.
Real shit. I remember.
But I truly don't believe she understood what it took to build an empire.
Amen.
The sacrifices it took.
Amen.
So therefore it put a strain on the relationship.
True story.
And through that came resentment that maybe she's doing more than me.
Mm-hmm.
But there's no way I'm doing 14, 15 hours a day, bro.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying?
Don't stop. When you come home, you've got to think about what you're doing today and what you're going to do tomorrow.
And then you've got
looking for the man to put food on the table.
Come on. And then you've got to be Peter Griffin. And don't get me wrong.
Peter Griffin.
Bro, at the time, I wasn't mature enough, you know what I'm saying, to understand how to be that man, how I am mature enough now, how to understand when you have a child with a woman, you're not no longer her main focus.
The child is the piece of fame.
Yes.
That's how it should be though, I think.
What do you mean?
The child should be.
No, it should be, but the same way, I still wanted the same attention. I didn't know it was going to shift like that.
Okay.
Whereas, boy, I don't exist no more.
Okay.
Do you get me? And I did exist, but not. I was now existed to cater for needs.
Yeah.
I didn't exist as...
As you met.
Yes.
Using it in that attention, that special attention.
I didn't know. But the thing is, I didn't know
any better. Dropping like it's hot.
Like, bro, what happened to me? Do you know what I'm saying? I know our son's here, and I understand.
But I still need to bust it down.
Come on, man.
She was busting it down.
Bust it, bust it, bust it. Is you? Fuck it. Two shots. Fuck it.
I'm not saying it's going too personal. Don't they talk about busting it down?
Cracking jokes.
Listen, we always busting it down, yo. Listen, what the point trying to make is, there's a time in your life when you're immature,
and the
things that matter to you shouldn't matter to you, because you know it's based on emotions and immature emotions and feelings. Mm. Whereas now the mature emotions and feelings. I understand dynamics.
Yeah, behind it all.
Behind it all, bro.
Yeah.
But you only can learn through experience.
But this is why I say we can't beat ourselves.
We can't blame ourselves.
And this is the thing,
bro.
As well. So like, in situations, you could be in a relationship with a woman, yeah? And there might be a reason why you feel like you need to go outside of that relationship, yeah? Because there's an aspect of that woman that doesn't sit right with you. But now, as a big man, what I realise is, rather than go outside of that relationship, you should probably just let that relationship slide.
Leave it.
When I say slide, no, let it go. Either you can talk about it and try and reason and work it out, but if you feel like you can't work it out, don't stay in a dead relationship, yeah?
And then right? try and get something
and then try
out
and
of
get something out of wrong. No, because that's you're starting something in the wrong way. So it's always gonna be wrong, because that girl's gonna know, oh, but you got a woman. And then you gotta ask yourself again, what scars is that woman working with? And she's gonna, at that stage in your life, pick up you, and you've got a woman, and you kid at home. Do you know what I'm saying to you? Like, that's not a good place.
Getting used.
That's a bad foundation to start on.
But that you get, and the thing is, though, well, for me, yeah, what I've learned now, enough man, yeah, back in the day, we'd say, oh, no, sorry, not we. Next man.
Jonathan and Bridget
would say, oh, I don't want my girl to give me head. I know them team there. You get me? So you, whatever gave me that, I don't know what you're talking about.
But you go out on the road to get that. You better you get
but
that
this
at home.
Time, better you get that at home.
Yeah, for real.
Do you know what I'm saying?
For real.
And maybe your woman wants to give it to you, but you play like, oh, dad, nah, we don't do them things.
Yeah.
I'm a Rasta man. But this time you're going out.
He's not talking about me, but
no, obviously I'm talking about you, but in general.
Yeah.
But you know what I'm saying?
Man say that type of thing.
Come on, bro. It's
so they end up doing madness outside.
At a road.
And they try to keep it very placid at home.
And very
and
missionary.
Then she's bored.
Come on, bro.
Thinking, what's this? She wants you to bust it down.
Come on, bro.
Basically.
You're grabbing up here and out a road.
And you know,
and they put some stroke at home.
If that.
Some
man are just keeping it straight. Mish-mash.
And then you blame them.
Yeah.
For the boring thing, because you're comparing it to the madness out the road.
Yeah, you're giving the madness, and you ain't giving her.
This
that,
is
that
what
wife.
I'm saying. We have
now
we've
got to take responsibility. So then that says to me, I can't really tell a woman how to make it.
Yeah.
I can't even tell a woman how to make it right. Obviously, men listening will probably get an idea of what they can do in it. But women, really and truly, it's a simple thing for me. For me, I just feel like peace of mind, man. You know what I'm saying to you, but at the same time as well, I think based on what you just said there, a really important thing here, no matter how hard it is, yeah. And if you can't work, if you can't do this, then again, it's a sign that the relationship's there. Communication. If you can't talk to your man or your woman can't talk, vice versa, then that's a big sign that the relationship is dead. Do you get me? You're supposed to be able to say to your man, yo, like, why don't we do this? Because
you know what it is. Sometimes, sorry to cut you again. It is said, you know, sometimes. Like,
yeah, but you're not in roundabout. I don't hear roundabout.
Now,
but I don't want this one saying, forget the roundabouts. Can I just say this?
No. It said, it's, you know how it's said, yeah. It says, it's in a saying.
My man,
no. Probably even that.
Sorry, Camarlo's girl.
I heard that. No, not even like that. Instead of saying, you know what, babe, I really love to like spice this thing up. And, you know, I'm thinking about. Blah blah blah.
Let's
kiss it, Naragni.
Kiss what? How was that? How would the blood clot do the girl? How will send you? Where the camera at? How will you try to blackmail the blood clot general? How will the camera at the girl? How will blood clot send you? How will you try to have bow you and bow out the blood clot warlord? Hey, how did the girl go blood?
Like he's saying, you don't do this. And you don't do that.
And someone's gonna get some, that's demotivating. But that's the reason what I'm trying to say about peace of mind. Again, it all falls into this is what I said, it's very simple that men have got it. It all falls into the same category, peace of mind. And I'll tell you straight, when I left home at 18 years to go uni in that year, you know, once I went home and I had like 1 week at uni, yeah, right? You know what? I said, I'm never going home again.
Mm-hmm.
And you know where that was? Didn't have no one nagging me. And the only person who would have nagged me is my mother. Do you get what I'm saying to you?
Mm-hmm.
Right, so from that point in time, I'm like, yo, this is what peace of mind looks like.
But okay, so peace of mind, if that's peace of mind, yeah, that means we don't want to be told nothing.
Nah, but I don't mind. Here's what I'm saying to give you an example, so I can give you a live example. I always say this anyway, yeah. With my mother, for example, yeah, every week, yeah, you have to clean the yard, innit? So imagine, bro, yeah, if I clean that house, yeah, for 51 weeks on a truck, on the 52nd, I don't do it.
No, do that a blood clotting in ya.
So
that's women.
Yeah, but then what I'm trying to say, yeah, and that's cool because obviously I've grown to understand that now. But unfortunately, no man was born big. Do you get me?
No.
So if I'm gonna accept the fact that I understand that things have changed now and that's women, yeah. right, then women will have to accept on their part that that's men, right? In order for it to work, you can't, yeah, have someone do something 51 weeks out of 52, and the 52nd when they don't do it, so get under them. Listen, this is, you can't, back to you can't do it. That's what I'm saying. So you gotta, you,
so
you,
so instead, okay, instead of us in our head looking at this is moaning, and this is what we do.
But it is moaning, though.
No, okay. It is. What it is?
Call a spade, not a round spoon.
What it is? Yeah,
it's moaning.
We run away.
No, but I didn't. I couldn't run away from blood clot.
You're letting him run away.
And he's a joke. Here's the joke, right? God. Just so you know, because again, he's saying this, yeah, and he's very righteous, yeah, and what he's saying is correct, yeah. But I don't want women to see this and think, oh, yeah, yeah, because then it's just a lie. The reality is, as a youngster, I couldn't get nowhere. Someone say to my mom, yo, listen, I'm doing this every week. I forgot to do this one time. And you go, she ain't care.
No.
Doesn't matter.
But women don't listen. Okay. I'll give you a
so women then, in the comments, if anyone sees this, yeah, are you all moaning here, right? And if you are, or if you're not, right, listen, are you willing to change? Or do you want to be that way?
Programming, bro.
Lose that program.
No, they can't.
TV program.
How can they lose that program?
Start watching TV.
Nah, man. Listen, bro.
How can you lose your program? Because I know that you've changed. How did I lose my program? Because I know that I've changed.
No, but this is the thing, though, bro. There's a makeup in a man
and a woman. That's
not what we're talking about. Men, yeah, yeah. There's a makeup in a man.
Yeah.
That maybe we can't change. Maybe we'll never be able to change a fact that we just want peace of mind. And if peace of mind just means no moaning, no nagging, then we'll never be able to change that. You get me? Unless we learn to accept that this.
So you're telling me, I'll tell you the truth. So you're telling me then this is peak, you know. Because you're telling me in your mind, yeah, that man just has to accept more. Nah, because I think it's not the case. I think that obviously, like you said, women are trying to tell us to do something, innit? So again, I feel like we can get rid of that moaning and nagging through communication. You don't have to moan and nag. You can talk, you can ask the question.
No, but all right, then look at this. Then maybe the question was asked once, twice, three times, and then they forget about the three, four times, and then like it's asked about something else. And then something else over here, and then it just gets to
so frustration. What's the solution in your mind?
My mind, yeah, bro, is that we just have to understand that women are going to be women.
Yeah,
I don't care if you can swap your woman 10 times.
Mm-hmm. That's true. Same problem.
So they're not the problem. We are the solution. No, there is no problem.
Oh, we're just the solution.
No, there is no right. There is no wrong.
Okay, we're just the solution then.
I believe, yeah, bro, that we have to be on a higher level.
No, I hear that.
Higher than our emotions.
I hear that.
Above our emotions.
I agree.
Above our feelings. Above our sometimes unrealistic expectations. Be above and be one within ourselves. You get me? And our higher power. And to the point whereas nothing bothers us.
That's true.
So it should, this example.
That's true, but here's what I'm saying now. So this is very true, right? And this is what we find. I think we'll admit, yeah, that nine times out of ten, this is where we find ourselves being and reminding ourselves that we've got to do this in it. And I would say to anybody, try to attain that in it. That is what I live to strive to do. And to anyone else, yeah, you have to pray because at the same time, you are just a human being. So I know that there is times, even when I just think, you know what, yeah, I'm just ready to explode.
Yeah.
Because at the end of the day, like being a bigger man, it will and it can take its toll, basically. So you just got to keep on trying. But just me, not just the fact that I know that people are human beings. I just have to say to you, when it feels difficult, you better pray or something,
bro.
Because that happens. Like trying to be the bigger person and constantly getting a kick is hard.
It sure is hard. But this is the thing now, yeah, bro. We're gonna go off topic for a little bit for a second because we need to come back. But my whole thing is, yeah. Battery died, but I saw the thing. As I was saying to my dad, I'm not ripping my stickers, you know, like me.
Yeah, what?
No,
anyway. Well, what did you say to your dad?
I said to my dad,
look for the keys.
No, I said to him, yeah, what is more important than making your wife happen? And it was Aiden, bro. He tried to, instead of answering the question, he's gone round the block. And trying to argue this, and I said, okay, that's cool. You still haven't answered the question, what can be more important than making your wife happy? So anyway, we went round about 10 times. Then literally, luckily for me, my mind was firing, bro. So I come, be an argument for everybody, I said, okay. I said, what's more important than your health? I'm his high horse now. Nothing. But without health, you have nothing.
Yeah.
So I'm like, cool.
Yeah.
So I says, if you don't have your wife, what do you have? Be a doctor,
yeah.
Do you get me? Mm-hmm. So I said, therefore, your wife is as important as your health, man. Mm-hmm. Simple.
True. That is true.
So therefore, back to the original question, what can be more important than making your wife happy? So this is my point now, Edgar. If your woman's nagging in your head,
mm-hmm.
and you're 100% committed to your woman, not nagging,
yeah, yeah,
not
yeah,
saying
yeah,
nagging, you met them in a bad look, in a bad way.
Yeah. If she's trying to make you better, but she needs to do things.
Come on, bro.
Yeah.
That you should have done anyway.
Mm-hmm.
And you have
or should be doing.
Or should be doing. Or mm-hmm. even so, yes. Something that she thinks.
Or things you could be doing better.
Could be doing better, bro.
Mm-hmm.
That possibly, she's the closest in your life
mm-hmm.
that you see every day, sleep, with
yeah, okay.
So she knows deep down what can better your life, which is going to better her life,
mm-hmm.
her kids' life. What's wrong with saying, okay, babe, or just, you know what, you're right, baby. I'll get onto that first thing tomorrow. Instead of saying, get off my back, blah, blah, blah. You're not, you get me, because at the end of the day, by saying that, it's going to make her happy.
Mm.
And doing the action is mm. going to make her happy,
definitely.
Which will in turn, long term,
mm-hmm.
get her off your back
mm-hmm.
and give you the woman
so
that gives you peace of mind.
I hear you. So do you believe then? Because again, many women will say,
mm-hmm.
even my Bridget I was speaking to the other day, he said to me, no matter what you tell us now, his name is Jenna.
I said, you're happy. Because you know what? I can know and say all this, but I also get fed up of trying to do it all, everything, and still get. So here's the thing, so you know what I'm going to say to you now, I feel like the standard that you hold yourself up to is a high standard.
It's admirable, and I swear like a trooper, and to the point, it's such a high standard that you hold yourself up to. I don't even think I've swore, but I probably swore, I swore once, and it's the one that I tried to hold myself up to, as you well know. So what is still difficult though, because as much as I do that, it would be nice, because I do what you talk about it, it would be nice. It'd be nice to get a woman who understands, because we definitely have to take responsibility, and I like the fact that we said this year, and especially you've said this year, we have to take responsibility for ourselves. It's hard not having a woman here, because it would be good to hear from a woman's perspective, yeah?
Mm.
So I've heard it from a manager's perspective, who I respect, and I can't even really fault what you've said, because this is how I live my life. Do you get me? So I just have to accept it. But it'll be interesting to know, and I'd like to know if there's a woman out there who can hear this, but still say, nah, we still need to come correct. Because at the end of the day, bro, yeah, I'm about evolving in it,
mm-hmm.
right? And the things that I was doing when I was a kid, I don't do them no more.
Mm-hmm.
So in the same way, the things I would probably tolerate from a young lady when I was a kid, I don't want to be tolerating them as a big man.
Mm-hmm.
Do you get what I'm saying to you? Like, it's...
Give me some examples.
It's like just getting on you for anything. Do you get what I'm saying to you? Just getting on you for anything. We should be dealing with that now. We say it's on us, yeah? But sometimes, it's not. Sometimes the issue is with themselves. They've got it hold on. Sometimes they've got it hold on. Sometimes, here's what I'm saying. Sometimes the issue is with what stuff that they've got going on in their lives. And I don't think it's enough, right, for me, yeah, on my own, to consistently accept, yeah, my failings, which I'm happy to do, yeah, right, but never even acknowledge hers, right, hold on, never acknowledge hers, because at the end of the day, if she don't acknowledge hers, and I don't acknowledge yours, and this is something I've experienced in real life here, I continue to grow and get better, but that person stays stuck. And if that person stays stuck here, unfortunately, it's going to go, for me personally, I don't know about you, it's going to go south.
And
because
that's life.
Okay. So then,
but then,
well,
you know what,
yeah,
bro, the bottom line,
but then why
is,
would you not want to bet, in the same way that you're talking about yourself, and I'm saying, boom, this is
no,
because you're bettering yourself,
yeah,
here,
go on.
Why would you not want your wife?
Of course you would.
Well, then, but you can't get better. Listen, she cannot get better.
Yeah.
If you let her,
no, you're not letting her.
So what
do
you do? So back to the question again. What are you gonna do? Because
all you've told me so far
is, anytime I said what do you do,
yeah,
you just tell me about what we've got to do.
Because I'm only taking responsibility.
Yeah, but follow that for a second. I'm asking you what about her.
I'm gonna answer you.
Thank you.
Look at this analogy, yeah.
Yeah.
If the head is strong,
yeah,
and the head is right,
yeah,
the body will follow, bro.
Okay.
So this is my point.
Okay.
This is my point. Yeah.
Yeah. You're the head.
I'm living in proof now. I'm the head.
Yeah, you're the head.
You get me? You cut the head off the snake.
That's what I'm saying.
The snake's dead.
Okay.
So the bottom line is, yeah, if the man is doing what he needs to do, and I don't know if this works for every woman, but I've tried it for myself, the woman will fall into place.
Okay.
Because I believe certain women feel that they have to do the man role because the man's not doing it.
Okay, that's true.
You get me? So it's like, someone's got to do it. Mm-hmm. Someone's got to fill in the spaces. Mm-hmm. But if the man is being the dominant, strong, assertive, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, come on. All right, look at the... I don't go pub. Do you get me? I have to bond really hard. You know this. You get me?
It's not about that last week. I'm joking.
You don't
That's what I took you.
Either way.
Nah. Genuinely longer than that.
All these things. This is from upbringing, my brother. You get me? This is from circle.
I rate you for it because many people can't do what you do.
Bro.
In that respect.
Literally, I don't eat meat no more like you. Total life changing for the better.
Yeah.
People can only respect that, bro. I don't argue as much.
Yeah, I try. It's dead.
It's dead.
It's dead, bro. So waste of hours,
days, blood pressure, heart, everything, bro. So my whole thing is,
God for you still.
If I love my woman enough to know that I'm with this woman, hopefully the rest of my life, bro. And it's that I don't give a shit. We don't own anybody. She can cheat tomorrow. I probably never know. I've come to realization we don't own. We can only take responsibility for ourselves. If she does anything, then she's fucked up. I tell you why. Because she's lost a man.
A good one. Yeah.
What she tries to do is none of my business. But if I find out, you don't know, right, bro. You don't know what time it is.
I co-sign this shit.
Her loss.
That's what I'm talking
because
about.
Because she's dealing with a real one right
now. So basically what I'm saying is there's got to be consequences.
If there's not going to be... sitting around some mama, man.
Well, okay.
Do you know what I'm saying?
But the other topic was like saying why are men turning soft? And obviously, I don't think we're going to touch on that now. Too tough. We can't touch on this. But I just feel that women out there, it would almost... If they don't know, if they've not got a perception, and not to say that some of you haven't, because I think many of you have, but some of you haven't, and some of you will hear that and think, oh, I ain't got to do nothing then. He's just going to come correct.
You're mad.
Yeah.
If you don't come correct.
You're going to have to come correct back.
100%, bro.
Otherwise.
Because you know what I'm doing, bro? I'm not, no one learns from talking.
Yeah.
I can say, if you say, do this, I need you to do that. You never do this. Bro, it's just, it's our form of moaning. But if we dictate through our own actions and our behavior, how we handle situations, bro, what they're learning, I don't give a shit.
Now they've got to learn. That's a
got
fact.
To learn.
That's a fact. And if they don't learn, this is the reality. If they don't,
they're done.
You're done.
Simple.
Do you get me? So even if it was for a woman to be out there to say, well, listen, as a woman, if you're doing everything that you're doing, it is my job to do
what I need.
That's
to
all
do.
I need to hear, isn't it?
And that's what
you get
happens.
Me because something it does, but it but it's what I'm saying. It does.
And if it doesn't happen, then you're in a wrong relationship.
Then you're in a wrong relationship, and that's what I'm saying. Because some people, because you know, what you're saying at the beginning. Like, we've done this and we've done that. Yeah, we have. But you see what it is? If a woman doesn't realise how she was complicit in her own demise
in that team, she will make the mistake of thinking,
yo, he was a bastard. He was this, he was that, he was this. And I'm happy to take all that, as I have done in my own relationships in life. And I'm like, I was. And I've changed, and I've changed, and I've changed, and I've done this, and I've changed, and I've done this thing, and I've gone on that journey, and I've changed, and I've changed it. Come back to speak to that person, and you're like, yo, you're still in the same place that you was in.
It's whatever years.
Do you get me? So I'm thinking... None of my business, but if you get a man, it's not a priority. But the problem is, I'm like, you get a new man now, though, and because of what I've done, but what I've done, you've been like this year. If you get this new man and you run this old program on this new man,
it's done.
You finished?
For growth, and to reprogram, you have to accept and take responsibility and forgive.
All of that, and forgive.
If you don't forgive yourself,
and yourself, you have to forgive yourself,
and the person,
both.
It's done.
And this is what I'm trying to say. So this is why with me, people might say, they'll ask me, all right, I still would love, I love the mother of my child because she gave me my child. That's my greatest creation. Do you get me?
And let's be real.
Yeah.
You love her. Not only because
not for many, many reasons because she's done good. Like, there's a point in time, it was close to everything else. Do you get me? So,
why not saying you're in love?
Yeah, not in love. No, not in love. Definitely not. But there's a big difference. But the thing is, here's the thing. For some of them, it's hard for them to even say that they love the father.
Yeah.
Do you get me?
They won't say it. They hate.
But this is where
their actions show hate.
Their hatred, which is where they're effed again.
And show the kids that they hate.
And it shows the kids hate. And this is where they don't realize they're scarring those children, by having that techno. They are.
They
are. Because the kid, yeah, like, look, the kid, yeah. And luckily, I say this, Carl, it would be if it wasn't for certain dads or mums on the other side where the dad's the piece of shit and the mum's forgiving and moving on because they need the move. They need the move.
They can tell the kids anything they want.
Yeah.
But time reveals
all. Everything. Yeah, yeah, for real.
Because over time, the information that they're fed with, mm-hmm. time will reveal that no, mm-hmm. this is not the reality.
Mm-hmm.
So that you can say whatever you like, mm-hmm. and if you're pushing out negativity, mm-hmm. it only shows the real you.
As a negative, that's the bottom line. And I think again, like obviously we didn't touch upon this whole male female role reversal, but this is, I suppose, this is why I support what you're saying. As the man doing the right thing, being the leader, that is you being a man in it. And I think society right about now is trying to tell you that we are equal, and we are equal, but we are different.
We're not equal.
Do you get me? You can have that thing there. If I say equal human beings, but obviously someone's gonna, or someone can choose to lead the relationship. What I'm saying is, a woman is a woman, and a man is a man.
Okay, we are equal, regardless whether we're equal and we say we're equal,
mm-hmm.
she still expects you to lead.
Yeah, to lead, yeah, yeah. But this is what I'm trying to say about the whole thing, but then at the same time, I was speaking to a brethren the other day who was saying that the woman, what was he saying again? The woman is everything, yeah, because she's the giver of life and all that type of thing. So, whereas we might be leading in one sense, they're bringing life into the earth in another sense.
Okay.
So, let's think, if there's no other word for equal, that's not even where I'm going with it. Where I'm going with it, yeah, is that we are different, bottom line. We are not the same. Do you get what I'm saying to you? So, where women are being encouraged to take on male traits, and I say male traits, women say he, her, whatever, fair enough, I don't want to upset anybody, but, like, there's things about a woman that are great that I can never be.
Mm-hmm.
There's things about a man that are great he can never be.
Mm-hmm.
You might think he can, but even right down the bottom line, you can't, we just cannot, because of the way we're made, physiologically we can't. And I was thinking, like, if you're trying to be a woman, here's where I'd struggle, say if I was trying to be a woman, really trying to be a woman, yeah, I don't understand the female code
because you're not a woman.
I'm not a woman. I don't understand the sisterhood because I'm not a woman.
You're not a woman.
You get
bro.
Me? If I was, you know what I'm saying? If you could let someone, a man of any description, of any gender, sexuality, come into
you. When we say trying to be a woman, you know, we're not trying to be gay, mm-hmm. trying to be feminine, but try and take on the woman role.
Yeah, you can't do it.
And I don't know exactly what the woman role is. If I'm going to be honest,
you're not a woman.
I'm not a woman, bro. But I know.
But there's things that are intrinsic to a woman that are not intrinsic to a man. And even then, talk about whatever, like, if it's gay or whatever and everything else. Yeah, you can be gay, you're gay if you're gay, but you're gay, but you're not a woman, are you?
Not a woman.
But you're gay.
You're just feminine,
but you're gay, you're not a woman.
You're not.
So, this is what I'm saying, like, it's a bit mad when women and men are trying to, you know what I mean? It's hard because you can't really. You can't, because you are that, and they are that, and you can still be gay, but you're a man. But I know that gay men know that they're gay men.
Bottom line.
Lesbian women know they're lesbian women.
Bottom line.
They're femmes or they're dumbs. They're not.
Mm-hmm.
Never trying to be men.
Mm-hmm.
They might have masculine traits, but they're women.
Let's pull this full circle, mm-hmm. yeah? I believe, this is only my belief, I could be wrong, but this is what I'm living by right now. It doesn't matter. I know, as you know, and you yourself, hundreds of women, bro. Do you know what I'm saying?
But is that you've had?
No. We know. I ain't had hundreds of women.
I'm joking.
You get me? And I don't think that's nothing to be proud of.
And that's dead. And that's another thing. This is what I'm saying. This is dead. Like, but that's another topic. That ain't even this touch. Like, but again, can just the reason why I've said that and I'm joking that it's dead is something to be proud of. Because I know that for some women, it's the perception because that's cool for men.
Mm-hmm.
And I think when you're a kid, you might also have the perception to have a lot of women mm-hmm. who's cool. But as you get older, it's like my pride is like, yo, the fewer men, the less women could say anything about me, the better. Well, do you get me? Exclusivity.
Let's not even get into that because we're going to go on a whole other tangent.
Exclusivity.
Right now.
Not too many people can be saying I've been there because you haven't been there. So
bro, exclusivity right now. Yeah.
Exclusivity.
And if I had known this years ago, I'd be a total different
price
man.
Price gone
now.
Up.
Come on, bro.
It gone up.
Come on. Back in the day, yeah.
Different value.
Even like uni days, early uni days, bro. Like, you know, you get there. Bro, university.
You were sowing your world oats.
Bro.
He's on some Lady Godiva shit. Lady Godiva.
Bro. When I tell you, bro, yeah.
You don't have to tell us.
Manny, yo.
Don't tell me.
Man, we're even trying to be a gallus.
Don't tell me.
But
see more
gallus levels.
Don't tell me.
Weren't even trying.
The wife might watch these.
I've got an honest relationship with my wife.
Sounds good, man.
And we talk.
It was the ultimate high society scandal. the beatdown of one of New York's most famous bad boy rappers by a woman. Jay-Z and Beyoncé Knowles Carter, the almost royalty power couple of hip-hop and R&B, set tongues wagging across the world because of this incident. Captured by CCTV cameras in an elevator at a fancy hotel in the Big Apple.
But what I'm trying to say is, yeah, I didn't know any better. True, if true. I wasn't chasing no gal, mm-hmm. I wouldn't be retaking years mm-hmm. at uni.
Mm-hmm. Not all of that. Keep 100.
Do you know what I'm saying? But my attention.
Or if you weren't chasing, if you weren't chasing gal, things that you probably did once or got one off, you wouldn't have 10, 4 or 5 off.
Come on, yard. Bro. Come on.
You get me?
Listen, bro. When I was at uni, yeah. I say I'm gonna blow my own trumpet. You don't know how man had to survive there. Mm-hmm. Man didn't go there with no allowance mm-hmm. and no big pocket from the parents. Mm-hmm. I went to uni, I've told honest with you.
Hustle game.
With £20 mm-hmm. and a sleeping bag.
Hustle bag. Hustle game.
Bro. And little bits and bobs. My mum, yeah, and dad, that's the first one in the family to go uni. Mm-hmm. They thought it was like the movies. Mm-hmm. You go there and they give you accommodation, you give it this, you give it. But I went there thinking, okay, this is the movies. Mm-hmm. The woman said to me, have you got your student loan? No, I ain't applying for nothing. You got your student accommodation? Mm-hmm. No. So what you doing here?
What you doing?
You come from Birmingham, what you doing? Bro, listen. Yeah. We had to get on the hustle game fast. Hustle game,
swiftly.
You get me?
Even talk
and I'm never going in that, but the bottom line is, yeah, I left with a house.
Yeah, yeah, that's what I'm saying. You left with more than you come with.
Left with more than I come with, bro.
With the back.
Do you know what I'm saying? Left with a legacy there. Legacy. To this day, name rings bells. Yeah, but the point I'm trying to make is, chasing women for the youth that are watching this, yeah, ain't cool. Don't be fooled.
It's not productive.
It's not productive.
Tony Montana says, isn't it? But I'm not going to say it because I can't remember the exact quote here.
What I try to tell you, this country, you got to make the money first. Then when you get the money, you get the power. Then when you get the power, then you get the woman. That's why you got to make your own moves.
But the reality is, yeah, don't chase them because the reality is you chase your dreams and your goals.
Thank you.
The women are going to chase you.
Thank you.
They will
listen,
chase you.
I've got a bedroom, yeah?
You ain't
got
to do nothing.
Zor Denim is dad passed.
Oh, you gave him the name.
I don't care. It's not even his real name.
All right, fair enough.
But his dad passed
Google it on YouTube.
YouTube it, your netty days.
Netty is what you really gave it away. What? Can't even cut that out.
Anyway,
yeah, go on.
His dad says, yeah.
Sorry for the dry feet, people.
His dad says, yeah, go on. Women are in every direction.
Is that what my dad says?
Listen. Women are in every direction, so if you are chasing women,
you go in every direction.
You're gonna listen or what?
Go on, sorry, brother.
Women are in every direction, so if you are chasing women, you have no direction.
Oh, cool.
You understand?
But that's the same as being in every direction, so yeah, I hear it still. He just sounds it more eloquently. But yeah,
but either way, bro,
it's the truth.
It's about if you're it's on your truth. Path, bro.
But, I mean, but you wouldn't be doing that.
You're not here you're like everywhere,
this.
Bro.
You'd be like this, come and on. This would be the women.
Come on,
and that would be you. Quite in true.
Come
see
on,
that?
Bro.
Quite in true. See what's happening.
Come on.
You ain't got to chase them, bro.
So listen, let's cut what's this up, bro. Car, you hear me?
All right. But anyway, that's how they pilot. I'm not sure if we touch upon everything, but.
And I think we're gonna check a little few. We're gonna send some notes.
Yeah,
next time.
Yeah, we just this is a practice.
But who cares?
Who's lucky enough to see this is gonna be the chosen few select committee to decide. And this moment is just epic.
Just get it uploaded, bro.
She doesn't care. I care.
This is episode one.
Landing cream his knees, but it don't matter though.
So I really enjoyed this conversation.
I enjoyed it.
Thank you.
You taught me some shit today, bro. I still like that.
Please,
shit.
Before you go, like, share. And subscribe.
It helps the algorithm.
It helps the algorithm, man. You know what I'm saying, man?
You know what I mean, man? For real shit.
Alright. Sing us out. Podcast. Go. How's it go?
I don't know.
Don't you know? Podcast.
You have to hire your artist to submit it.
Podcast. You don't know? Podcast.
Your mom's